Fashion research work which identifies the survey of different design rules based on techniques for facilitating layout problems, which is a part of collaboration between Quartz Laboratory of Higher Institute of Mechanics of Paris and Mechanics Modeling and Production Laboratory of National Schools of Engineering in Sfax, Tunisia, supervised by Professor Manzo Gatri, Dr. Roberta Acosta Afonso, Professor Fauzi Masmoudi, and Professor Mohamed Hinder. Let's begin by the outline. This talk is divided into 5 parts. First, I would like to start with an introduction which includes context and problematic. Secondly, I will give an overview of facility layout problems. Then, an overview of different design rules is provided. My fourth point will be about the different resolution approach used to solve layout problems. And finally, I will provide the current plans and the future scope of work. So, first of all, we should know what means the facility layout problems. Facility layout problems is an arrangement of everything needed for production of wood or delivery service. A facility may be a machine room, work center, a machine, a department, or a warehouse. These problems have many applications in real layout situations, including layout of school, layout of hospitals, and layout of industrial systems. However, the main attentions of the research in this area have been focused on the layout of manufacturing systems. So, it is noteworthy to know that layout problems is a significant contributor to manufacturing performance. As shown in this figure, only 5% of time is spent on the machine and about 95% of time is spent on moving and waiting. And according to another study, about 20% to 50% of the total operating cost in manufacturing are attributed to material handling costs. So, one of the prime objectives of such company is to find an optimal arrangement of their facilities, machine or department in a given area, in order to minimize the material handling cost. So, in this case, the most important question is what is the best way to arrange the machine? Should be arranged in T shape or V shape or U shape in order to obtain an efficient layout. So, several types of workshop exist in the literature. In the second section, I will provide an overview of facility layout problems and the different factors that differentiate the natures of the problem. Based on the variety of product and the production volumes, 4 types of layout exist in the literature, which are fixed layout, process layout, cellular layout, and product layout. In the fixed layout, the product doesn't move. It is the different resources that are moved to perform the operations on the product. Process layout groups facilities which have a similar function together. In cellular layout, facilities are grouped into cells to process the families of similar parts. And in finally, in the product layout, the facilities are organized according to a successive sequence of manufacturing operations. So, facility layout problems deal with various characteristics. Such as the number of floor, we can find the single floor layout and multi floor layout, facility dimensions, equal area facility layout problems and unequal area facility layout problems, facility shapes, regular shapes and irregular shapes. According to statistical studies, it has been observed that the single floor layout are more often aggressive than the multi floor layout, and the unequal area with regular shape are more often tackled than irregular shape layout problems. Another classification according to the nature of problems, we find static facility layout problems and dynamic layout problems. The static facility layout problems aims to arrange facilities in a given area in order to minimize the material handling cost. In this category, we suppose that the data related to material flow remain unchangeable over a long time. However, dynamic layout problems take into account the different change of material flow in different periods. layout problems are more often addressed than dynamic facility layout problems. And like any other problems, the objective there are two types of objective functions, which are single objective function and multi-objective functions. And for layout problems, another classification according to the type of objective, you can find quantitative objective functions and qualitative objective functions. For the quantitative objective functions aims to minimize the material handling cost, to maximize the adjacency scope, and for example, maximizing the space utilizations. And for the qualitative objective functions, we aim to maximize safety, flexibility, and security. So to recap, layout problems aim to assign machines on the shop floor, subject to the following constraint, locations and area, budget constraint, flow movement, by avoiding bypassing and avoiding bypassing, and positioning constraint, by avoiding overlapping. That's all about the different factors that constrain the nature of layout problems. And now I will give an overview of different design rules. The main design rules in layout problems are the minimizations of no value added activity, minimize unnecessary travel. For example, we can avoid the overlap of flow. We can avoid the bypassing, the backtracking, and keep intact the different obstacles. So by applying these different design rules, we can move from these configurations to this configuration. Now we will present the different resolutions approach applied in layout problems. Several words have been done in facility layout problems. The solutions methodology can be divided into exact methods, restex methods, and meta-restex methods. The exact methods such as dynamic programming and branch and bound have been applied to solve the small size layout problems. For example, the number of facilities is less than 10. In the restex method, three classes exist in the literature: construction algorithms, improvement algorithms, and hybrid algorithms. For the construction algorithms can be used to provide an initial solutions for the improvement algorithms. And the improvement algorithms start with an existing layout. The existing layout can be improved by exchanging the locations of different facilities. And finally, for the hybrid layout, they integrate the construction algorithms and improvement algorithms. In order to obtain good solutions, recently, meta-heuristic methods have been successfully applied, such as particle swarm optimizations, taboo search, and genetic algorithms to solve large size layout problems. It contributes to obtain good solutions in a reasonable time. Is to minimize the material handling cost, to maximize the satisfactions of distance request, and maximizing the satisfaction of weighted adjacency. To be more realistic, some research can treat more than one objective function, but in both cases, three sets of constraints are usually adopted, which are floor space constraints, to force each facility to be within the horizontal and vertical limits of the workshop, overlapping constraint to avoid the overlapping between facilities, and the distance constraint to define the distance between all pair of facilities. And to solve layout problems, exact and approximated methods are still used to solve these problems. Meta-heuristics methods are more and more reported in the recent year to cope with the realistic layout characteristics. So, based on the above finding, we can note that layout problems is an open research area. Several directions can example, we should also consider the locations of the docks and paths for the transportation device. We should also consider the space needed for movement and parking of trucks and the locations of docks for the warehouse. For example, we can also avoid suggested a model that avoiding the bypassing, the backtracking, and eliminating the crossing of all kinds of goods in order to reduce the risk of collisions. Another remark that the most of the paper use a quantitative model, but to be more this model is good for the formulated models, but not necessarily for the real world problem. So qualitative requirements such as safety, security, noise, and flexibility can be taken into account for into the models in the modeling phase. And finally, we can suggest to extend the facility layouts in 3D, from 2D to 3D, where a new spatial constraint can be considered. So that's all. Thanks for your attention.